लास्ट मिनट प्रिपरेशन टिप्स, मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स फॉर बिटसैट, व्हाट आर द मिस्टेक्स यू नीड टू अवॉइड इन बिटसैट एग्जाम, पेपर अटेम्प्टिंग स्ट्रैटेजी ऑफ बिटसैट, बिटसैट कट ऑफ एंड लास्ट बट नॉट लीस्ट चीट कोड्स ऑफ बिटसैट. व्हाट आर चीट कोड्स? चीट कोड्स आर नथिंग बट How can you use some tricks and score more marks in BitSat, okay? At the end of this video, you're going to get a lot more of useful information. So make sure you watch this video till the end. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more videos, okay? So watch this video till the end. So now let's begin this video without any delay. First, let's see what are the last minute preparation tips for BitSat, okay? So first important thing is, Concentrate on high weightage topics. This is the first important tip, okay? You need to concentrate on high weightage topics. High weightage topics are nothing but the topics which are having utmost priority. Those are high weightage topics. Concentrate on those topics in order to get a very good score, okay? So in this video only, I'm going to give you high weightage topics also. Next is practice weak topics and subjects. Okay, see if you are weak at any particular topic, if you are not confident with any particular subject, then concentrate mostly on those subjects and topics, okay? So go for mock test. What is the use of mock test? Once you give the mock test, then you will understand where you are wasting your time, in which particular subject or in which particular topic you are getting stuck, and how is your time management, all, and in which particular subject you need more preparation. All these things you can understand only after giving mock tests. So make sure you give mock tests and analyze your mock tests, okay? And next important thing is previous papers, okay? So at least go through last 4 to 5 years previous papers. You'll understand what level of questions are coming and which kind of questions are coming, and so all these things you can understand only once you go through the previous papers. So make sure you go through at least last 4 to 5 years of papers, okay? So next is maintain short notes. So short notes in the sense, take a short notebook and write important formulae and write important concepts in that, so that just before the exam also you can just have a quick revision with the help of that short notes, okay? Because you know at the end of the day, formula is very important in order to solve problems, and concepts are very important in order to get a good score. That's why maintain a short notes in which you need to record all the important topics, important concepts. Okay, so now let's see what are the most important topics subject wise, okay? So if you prepare the topics which I am going to give you as important topics, you are easily going to get 90% of marks, okay? So first let's see what are the important topics coming to physics. You need to concentrate on heat and thermodynamics. Very, very important concept. At most prioritized concept. Very, very important. Next is magnetic effect of current. And magnetism. Very, very important. Okay. Wave motion, current, electricity, current, electricity. Next is electrostatics. Electrostatics, very important. Wave optics. Okay, so these are at most important topics coming to physics. Now let's see what are the most important topics coming to chemistry. First most important topic is chemical bonding. Chemical bonding, it has high weightage. Very, very important topic. Next is biomolecules. Biomolecules. Carboxylic acid and its derivatives. Carboxylic acid and its derivatives. Okay. So next is atomic structure. Atomic structure. Very important. P block elements. P block elements. Mole concepts. Mole concepts. Last but not least, alkanes, alkenes and alkynes. Okay, I'm just putting AAA. Understand it. Alkanes, alkenes and alkynes. Okay, so these are most important topics coming to chemistry. If you want, just take a quick screenshot. Now let's see what are the most important topics coming to mathematics. First most important topic with high weightage is circles. Circles. Okay, next is straight lines. Very, very important. Pair of straight lines. Pair of straight lines. Okay, very important. Vectors. Continuity and differentiability. Differentiability. Okay, so differential equations. Differential equations, very important. Complex numbers. And last but not least, binomial theorem. Binomial theorem. Okay, so these are the most important topics coming to mathematics. Okay, students, take a quick screenshot. Now let's see what are the most important topics coming to English. Okay, coming to English proficiency. Okay, so coming to English, concentrate on synonyms and antonyms. See, most of the students will be confused. Synonyms means meanings. Okay, antonyms means opposites. Okay, antonyms means opposites. Anto, just remember it as anti. Anti means opposite, right? So remember like that. Next is sentence completion. Very important. Sentence completion. Okay, and next is rearrangement of jumbled words. Rearrangement of jumbled words, very important. Rearrangement of jumbled words and one word substitution. These four topics are really important coming to English. Okay, so now let's see what are the important topics coming to logical reasoning. You need to concentrate on figure formation and analysis. Figure formation and analysis. Okay, figure matrix, very important. Analogy test, numerical and alphabetical series, very, very important. Last but not least, logical deduction. Okay, so these are very, very important topics coming to logical reasoning. Okay, now let's see paper attempting strategy. Okay, what is paper attempting strategy? Okay, if you follow this strategy while attempting your paper, you're going to get a very good score. Okay, so coming to paper attempting strategy, first important thing is, we all know exam duration is 3 hours, which is 180 minutes. Okay, so coming to 180 minutes or coming to 3 hours, divide into three equal halves. Okay, 1 hour, 1 hour, 1 hour. Altogether, exam hour of 3 hours, exam duration of 3 hours, we are dividing into three equal parts, which is 1 hour each. Okay. In the first hour, target to attempt 60 questions. Okay, in the first 1 hour, you need to target at least to attempt 60 questions. Okay, how? I'll tell you. Okay, so in this first 1 hour, you need to concentrate on easy questions, direct questions. Easy questions means the questions which you know very well, concentrate on them. And direct questions means, once you read the question, you will directly get to know the answer, right? So those kind of questions you need to concentrate and solve in this first hour. And in this first hour, you need to solve at least 60 questions. Remember this, okay? In the second hour, target to attempt at least 40 questions, okay, in the second hour, right? And these 40 questions you need to, in this second hour, you need to concentrate on solving moderate questions. You need to solve moderate questions and indirect questions. What are moderate level questions? Moderate level questions means like a bit tough questions, not so tough, but a bit tough, little bit tough questions. You need to solve moderate questions and questions which are indirectly asked. So these two questions you need to solve in second hour. Okay, so in the left over third hour, you need to solve at most difficult questions. Okay, difficult questions and tricky questions in the third hour. So students, in the entire 3 hours, first hour and second hour is at most critical time. Okay, you need to utilize them, the perfect time management skills. Okay, so first 2 hours is very, very important. Whatever questions are left after solving after both hours, you can concentrate them on third hour. Okay, in the first hour, aim to attempt 60 questions and solve easy and direct questions. In the second hour, aim to attempt at least 40 questions. And in the second hour of 40 questions, you need to solve, you need to target moderate and indirect questions. And in the third hour, concentrate on difficult and tricky questions. Okay, so this is the first paper attempting strategy. Now, I'm going to tell you from which subject you need to solve in order to get a very good score in BITSAT. Okay, you need to start solving paper with English. Okay, first start solving with English and then go with chemistry, next physics, next logical reasoning, and then you can go with max. In this sequence, you need to solve your paper. Why? Why? Because coming to English, 80% of the questions will be direct and easy. So first start solving with English, then next easiest paper is chemistry, and then is physics. Like this, in this sequence you need to start solving paper, okay? So it will be really helpful, and you can get a really good score, okay? Now let's see what are the common mistakes which are needed to be avoided by all the students, okay? Common mistake you need to avoid is inspect your system. Okay, what is meant by this? See, we all know this is completely online exam. Most of the students will be in a hurry and they don't check their system. Later they'll realize that there is some issue with their system, and then they'll tell the same to invigilator and time will be running. So first of all, inspect your system, check whether the system is working fine or not, okay? So most of the students will not do this, and this is the common mistake which they does, okay? They don't check their system. You need to avoid this mistake, and you need to inspect your system whether it is working fine or not, okay? So next is go through instructions, okay? All the instructions are very, very important. You need to go through each and every instruction. Don't waste your time. Read each and every instruction carefully. You must read all the instructions very carefully to avoid all kinds of confusions. Thing which you need to do is read question paper first. Okay. First, go through entire question paper. Why I am telling you this is, since you go through entire question paper, then only you will understand is the paper lengthy or is the paper easy, difficult. All these things you can understand only after going through question paper once. Okay, so based on the level of the question paper, you can allocate your time equally. So it really helps if you go through question paper once. Okay, and next is avoid wild guess. Avoid wild guess, okay? So first three answers. So for example, first three answers you got as A, and you don't know what is the answer for fourth question. You should not think like, okay, first three answers are A, so let me put the fourth answer also as A. This should not be done. There should not be these kind of wild guesses, okay? So read every question twice. If you're not understanding the question, read again and again. And few questions will be tricky. You need to read them at least twice, then only you'll understand them. So coming to the cutoff for BE honors chemical, cutoff is going to be 275 plus, okay? For BE honors civil, cutoff is going to be above 270. For BE honors electrical and electronics, cutoff is going to be high. It's going to be above 330. 330 plus, okay? For BE honors mechanical, cutoff is going to be 310 plus. For BE honors computer science, cutoff is going to be, For MSc chemistry, the cutoff is going to be above 260 in BITS Pilani. Okay, so coming to MSc economics, cutoff is going to be above 300. Okay, so this is just an expected cutoff. Exact cutoff will be based upon many things. If the paper is really easy, then cutoff will increase. If the paper is difficult, the cutoff will come down. So, exact cutoff will be based on many other things. So, coming to last minute preparation tips, first most important tip is don't start with new topic. Don't start new topics. See, when you're left only with few days or few weeks for your exam, so it's better not to start any new topic, because if you start any new topic, you will be confused and you will also tend to forget the things which you have already studied. So don't go with new topics. Okay, cheat code is no extreme values. What does this mean? For example, let's think there is a question and there are four options. Option A is 2, option B is 4, option B is 8, option D is 21. Okay, so see, out of these four options, which is having extreme value? Extreme means different value. This is having different value, so you can't put this as answer. Okay, you have to guess only, you have to put only one of these three options as the answer. Okay, you should avoid extreme values. Okay, do no extreme values. Each cheat code kartu vente ippudu manam chuddam. Okay, so for question undi and four options icharu, 2, 4, 8, 21, ivi four values. Aa four values lo మొత్తం డిఫరెంట్ గా విభిన్నంగా ఉన్న ఆప్షన్ ఏదైతే ఉంది, ఇది 21. మిగిలినవన్నీ దగ్గర దగ్గరగా ఉన్న ఆప్షన్స్, కానీ ఇది మాత్రం చాలా డిఫరెంట్ గా ఉంది. ఇలాంటి డిఫరెంట్ ఆప్షన్ ని మాత్రం పెట్టుకోవద్దు. గెస్ చేస్తున్నప్పుడు దీన్ని అవాయిడ్ చేయండి. మిగిలిన త్రీలోనే ఒక ఆన్సర్ అనేది మీరు పెట్టుకోవచ్చు. ఓకేనా? సో నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేసి ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్, నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్. Next is all of the above, none of the above. See, when you have all of the above as one of the option, you can go for it. You have all of the above as one of the option and you don't know what is the correct answer, then there are high chances that all of the above is the correct answer. Then you can happily go for it. Okay, and if you find none of the above as one of the option and if you don't know what is the correct answer, don't go for it. Okay, there are very least probabilities of none of the above being the correct answer. Okay, so that's why always go for all of the above and never go for none of the above. Okay, so ippudu manam all of the above, none of the above options ento chuddam. Okay, oka question undi, aa question options vachesi all of the above undi and meeku answer correct ga telikapothe appudu meeru all of the above anedi pettochu, endukante chaala chances unnai all of the above correct avadaniki. So ilanti appudu meeru all of the above ఆప్షన్ చూస్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. సెకండ్ ఏంటంటే, మీకు మీకు ఇచ్చిన ఆప్షన్స్లో నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌ ఉంది అండ్ మీకు ఆ కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్ తెలియదు అన్నప్పుడు నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌ చూస్ చేసుకోకండి. ఎందుకంటే చాలా తక్కువ కేసులో, చాలా తక్కువ ఛాన్సెస్లో నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌ అనేది కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్ అవుతుంది. సరేనా? నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేసి ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్. నెక్స్ట్ ఈజ్ ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్. So what is elimination method? When you have four options, using your logic, using the concept which you know, which is related to this question, try to eliminate the irrelevant options. Okay, so then out of four options, after eliminating the irrelevant options, you will be left with only two options. Then you can happily guess and put one of these options. Okay, this is called elimination method. Using your logic and your common sense and the concept which you know related to the question, just eliminate irrelevant options. Okay, so ippudu manam elimination method ante ento chuddam. Elimination method entante, yeah, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching and all the very best for your exam.